Can we start with team news then ahead of Mansfield? We know Andy Cook's not available for you, is he? But anything else you can tell us?
Not really. Obviously, it was a good win, and only thing that really changed is Cookie's unavailability. And, you know, we've got a decision to make on who to put in his position. And we'll hopefully make the right call.
What are your options there then? How are you thinking?
Obviously, we've got a lot of different options in that position. Obviously, we've got Danny Rowe, who's who played before Cookie arrived, really, and he was the nine that was playing most games. Obviously, got Clayton, who's very experienced and still causes threats to the opposition. We've also got Roman as well. We've got Charles Vernon, who can play in that position. So we've got options in that position, yeah.
Can I ask you about some of the other players? How close are they to return, like, you know, Bryce, Susanna and Lee Novak, for example?
Bryce, I said it last week as well. He's around a 2 week mark. We believe he's currently outside when the first team are training. He's doing little bits with the physios, so we're ticking him over and looking for a possible return as soon as possible. We had a little bit of a setback with Lee, and you know he's probably not going to be available for the next few weeks.
So that makes it even more impressive, does it not, that you've managed to adapt despite the injury situation?
Yeah, you know, it's something that every team has to deal with, and you know, we're no different with that. And the January window was really important for us to strengthen in depth, and you know, we've managed to do that in the positions that we needed.
How far is Billy Clark away from maybe starting, Connor?
He obviously came on the last game and, you know, had an impact. And like I said before, he's a great character. So we're looking to build his minutes up. He was a starter before his injury. So he'll be looking to get back into the team as soon as possible. But we've got a job to do and make sure he returns safely.
And Gareth Evans wasn't starting on Saturday. What's the situation with him then at the moment, Connor?
Yeah, he went off and the game before last, and he sort of had a little niggle and went down the tunnel. You know, he's not a bad one. I said we had some good news on it. So hopefully, you know, soon, touch and go maybe for tomorrow, but we'll see.
And just on one more player, Jordan Stevens, how's his progress been with you? Are you finding him since he's arrived?
Yeah, he's a really talented player. And he's having to sort of fight for his minutes. He's had a few opportunities and, you know, I think he just got to keep impressing when he does come off the bench. But what I would say is his mentality when he does come on, and we've been often in front in the game, and he's come on and had to really work for the team and do his defensive part, and which he's more than happy to do as well.
How much did you learn from your side at the weekend, Connor? Because I know Mark talked about it being an ugly win as such, but you can find beauty in that, can't you, as well?
Yeah, 100%. You know, when you look at the mental attributes of the players and what they have to go through, and you know, when teams are throwing a lot of bodies in the box, you know, players have to adapt quickly and respond to those problems and find the solutions. Probably would say, personally, you know, the performance in the last 20 minutes in terms of the organisation wasn't probably where it needed to be. The players are aware of that, but I think from the mentality and the grit that they needed to take to win the game was top draw, like you say, yeah.
Analysis is a huge thing, as you say. Would you say that, you know, you and Mark are particularly like a sort of the new breed of coaches now that are totally on top of all the stats and the analysis and the useful data, if you like?
I think we just we found a way of working. You go on courses as coaches and you learn new things and you start to adapt and find what works for you. I probably wouldn't say that we're a new breed or anything like that. We just like knowing as much as we can about the opponents and preparing as well as we can.
What do you think then has been sort of the biggest influence that you've had? Because it has been some incredible turnaround.
In terms of?
To make this sort of winning mentality and to get the team playing how they needed to play to get results in this division, because it wasn't happening before.
Yeah, there's probably a lot of factors involved. We can't put it down to just me and Mark and the staff. You know, the players have got to perform. Hopefully we've given them some clarity and they've gone and done the job. But again, we've had the window, you know, and we've tried to strengthen and make sure that we've got players who are on the bench who can impact the game and change the game. And I think the camaraderie around the place and the building is really good, and people get on, and everybody who's in the building, we had a choice. We wanted everybody to work and as hard as they can, to go over and beyond. If that's, you know, as a staff member, if that's as a player, we want to instill that you know, you got to work for what you get. So, you know, that's probably the biggest thing, that the winning mentality and the competitive drive.
And are you expecting Mansfield to be far different from the side that Bradford played early on in the season and won pretty well, actually?
Yeah, obviously they've got a new manager who's been in there for a couple of months now, I think. And, you know, they went on a fantastic run. You know, we've seen a lot of them. You know, we're impressed by how they play and the energies that they use. So I think, again, it's going to be a real tough test.
And just finally, Connor, the next thing will be managing expectations, won't it? If this run continues, because everybody's talking about how close you are to the top end of the table rather than being at the bottom end.
Yeah, we keep level, we keep grounded, we keep approaching the next game the same as the last in terms of trying to win, trying to be positive, and doing our best to perform.
Good luck with it, Connor, as well.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Hi, Connor.
Hi.
As you say, you taking it every game as it comes, just only looking to the next game. But the remit when you came in was to save the club from relegation out of the Football League. And pretty much you've done that, and certainly in terms of points and league position, you're closer to the top of the table. At what point do you reassess the goal of what you want from the club this season?
I think, again, with the mentality that we have, and everybody, the club's in the same boat where... we're not getting too ahead of ourselves in any way at all. We're again approaching every game in the same manner, where we go out there and we, you know, give our best. If things change down the line and things happen, we might potentially have conversations. But ultimately, our goal is to win the next game and have that mindset, and that's how we're working.